the Neanderthals were failing to cope with the changing conditions. A struggle uncovered in a cave known as the Tunnel of Bones.
Oh, wow. So this is the famous El Cedrón cave?
Yes, yes.
It's got more character than I was expecting, actually. Yeah.
Here is where we found 2,500 Neanderthal bones. We found 13 Neanderthal individuals of different ages and sexes.
Such a diverse group in terms of individuals, all found in one spot.
Genetic studies told us that they are related, so it's a family group. We know, for example, that one female, we are not completely sure, genetic information said, was red hair.
And you know, when you say that one of those people had red hair, it suddenly brings just fossils, really, to life. It's a cave that's filled with ghosts.
We think these people were killed by other group.
This was not a natural death. Cracked skulls and precise cuts on the bones suggest that this was a brutal massacre. 13 people killed by another Neanderthal group. But closer analysis of their remains revealed an even darker truth.
So what do the bones actually tell us?
The first thing the bones tell us is that this Neanderthal group cannibalized another group.
They were really eating these 13 individuals?
Yeah.
So how do we know that this was cannibalism as opposed to just straight up murder, or for that matter, an animal coming?
Well, because we have seen in the bones what we call cut marks. And also, we have found a lot of bones broken just to get the narrow.
Yeah.
So there are the both things. We have cut marks and then they broke the bones to get the narrow.
Yeah, if you're getting bone marrow, that's is an indication of cannibalism,
yes,
sure.
That is.